Good morning, students. Today we are going to see this topic, division of polynomial, also the remainder theorem. Okay, so in the last year we have already learned into the polynomial lesson division of the polynomial, right? So if one of the polynomial p of x is divided by the another polynomial g of x, when you will carry out the this division, you will get the quotient. Quotient means what? We can write it is q of x, and the remainder then means remainder is r of x, right? So simply for this, we will see, we have already learned that one relation about the division, right? Division of the numbers. So that is divided equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder, right? So simply we will see in this example. Suppose 27 divided by 5. Okay, so 27 divided by 5, how you will do this? 27 divided by 5, so that is 5, 5s are 25. So you will get remainder is 2. Okay, so this is called divided. This is quotient. Okay, and this is divisor, and this is your remainder. Okay, so this relation we have learned already, divided equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so in case of the polynomial, if we can say that if one of the polynomial p of x is divided by the another polynomial g of x means here your divisor, then you will get the quotient q of x and the remainder r of x. So in case of the polynomial, we will write this divided in this form. Suppose the polynomial p of x equals to what is your divisor, that is we are taking here g of x into quotient is q of x plus remainder is r of x. Okay, now for this, what is your divided equals to 25, sorry, what is your divided here? In this case we will write this is the divided equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so what is your divided is 27 equals to divisor is, what is your divisor? 5 multiplied by quotient is 5 plus remainder is 2. So if you multiply this, 5 5s are 25 plus 2, 27. So you will get the divided, right? So for this relation, we will take one of the polynomial is divided by the another polynomial, and we will write in this relation. Okay. Now we will see the one of the example of the polynomial for the division. Divide the p of f of x, here I am taking here f of x equals to minus x square plus 2x to minus 2x minus 7 by g of x, means it is, this is your divisor, minus 2 plus x, right? So first, what we have to do when you will, means we have to divide this one of the polynomial by another polynomial, okay? So by actual division method, in this actual division method, what we have to do here? See, this f of x, whatever it is given, first we have to arrange the given polynomial into the descending order. Descending order means exponents order we have to check, and greater number means greater exponent we have to write first, that everyone know how to write the descending order. Second thing is that if when you will write the descending order and greater exponent having that term having the negative sign, then we can change the negative sign into the positive form, right? We can change the negative sign into this positive sign. But when you will change this sign, then automatically you have to change all the signs. For example, suppose this is the negative. Suppose this is the negative, and when you will arrange the descending order, minus 2x cube, then minus x square, minus 2x, minus 7 is there. Actually, now in this example, it is positive, right? But if it is the negative sign, then first we have to arrange the given terms from this polynomial into the descending order of exponent. Okay, then if the first term having the greater exponent, if it is negative, then we can convert into positive, and whatever the positive, if negative is positive, we have to convert into positive form like this. Understood? So here it is not like this. Here first term is only positive, you are only here already positive, right? And these are negative terms, so there is no need to change the sign. Okay, if this sign is negative, then we have to change all the signs. Means if you have done positive, whatever, if it is negative, then we have to convert it positive. If it is positive, we have to convert it to negative sign, and so on. Okay, means we have to simply change the sign. Understood? So now here, this 2x cube minus x square minus 2x and minus 7, we have written into the descending order of exponents and divided by, here this g of x, it is given minus 2 plus x. So x first we write x minus 2. In this way we have to write. Now we will carry out this division. Here 2x cube minus x square minus 2x minus 7 divided by x minus 2. Okay, then how to carry out this division? We have to take this x minus 2, then we have to select from this first term. First term is what? 2x cube. So that we have to write here, 2x cube. Understood? Now next, what we will do? Here we have to find out one of the number by which, if you will multiply to this first term from the divisor, then you will get 2x cube. Now you will get this term. Okay. Now which number? Here 2. Is there 2? Not there. Means of course we have to take here 2. So 2 into x, you will get 2x only. But we want 2x cube. Here already 1 is there. And here 3 is there. We want to make it 3. We have learned exponent power rules. When bases are same and exponents are different, then in multiplication we will add the exponent. So that same concept we have to use. So here x raised to 2. See here what is their operation? Multiplication is there. So x raised to 2, and here x raised to not there, anything means 1. So 2 plus 1, 3, multiplication, we are adding the exponent. Okay. So 2x cube. Now we sign is here minus 2 2's are 4x square. Understood, everyone? So here which number we have written here? 2x square. So that is your term 2x square. Correct? So minus 2x square, then minus 4x square. So here 2x cube. Okay. Now we will do the subtraction. Now here this minus sign, and here this number is already positive. So minus plus will come minus, and minus minus will come plus. Okay. So here this 2x cube and minus 2x cube get cancelled. Here minus x square and 4 plus 4x square. So this term is positive, this term is negative. Now we cannot take this sign because of this subtraction this sign get changed. This minus minus got plus. Okay. So plus 4x cube minus x plus 4x square minus x square. So one negative, one positive, we have to go to subtraction and give the greater number sign. So greater number sign is positive, right? So 4x square minus x square, that is your 3x square. So no, their sign means positive sign is already. Okay. Then carry out this 2x as it is minus 7. Now same procedure we have to do. X minus 2 multiply by which number you will get? Outside, what term is remaining? 3x square minus 2x minus 7. So we have to take 3x square first term. So 3x square. Okay. Simply, what number should be there? 3. Here x is how many times? 1 times we need. X is 2 times. So one more x we need, right? So 3 into x, 3 into this 1, that is 3. And x into x, it is x square. Okay. then his sign is here minus 3 2s are 6 and there x. Okay, so minus 6x. So which number, which term we have taken here? Positive or negative? Positive. So plus 3x. So you got here 3x square minus 6x. Okay, we will do the subtraction. Now this number is also positive. So minus plus minus will be there and this minus minus plus will be there. Okay, so minus 3x square minus 3x square get cancelled. Plus 3x square minus 3x square get cancelled. Then minus 2x plus 4x. So plus minus minus subtraction we have to do. So 6 minus 2, 4, that 4x. And this is minus 7. Okay, again we will carry out this. This your again x minus 2, it is your divisor. Now what we got here? 4x minus 7. So what is the last here term? That is the 4x. So by which number if you will multiply to this x, then you will get 4x. That is 4, of course, 4 into x, 4x minus 4 to the 8. Okay, so which number? Plus 4. Right? So here 4x minus 8. Here we have to do the subtraction. This positive number, so it becomes negative, and this minus minus plus will be there. Now this 8 having this sign, plus sign. So 4x minus 4x get cancel. 8 minus 7, that is 1. So you got this is remainder. So what this is? This is divided. This is your quotient. This is your divisor. And this is remainder. Okay, so we will write in this form, divided equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so here we will write this divided equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so here this polynomial p of x, that is your f of x, which is divided by g of x into quotient q of x plus remainder r of x. So what is the f of x or p of x? That is the polynomial is given 2x cube. We can write this minus x square plus 2x cube minus 2x minus 7 equals to what is your divisor? Minus 2 plus x into what you got the quotient? 2x square plus 3x plus 4. Okay, so we will write what is the f of x. It is given 2x cube minus x square minus 2x minus 7 equals to what is the g of x? X minus 2, it is your g of x. What you got the question? 2x square plus 3x plus 4. This is your question. Plus remainder you got 1. Understood everyone? So if you will simplify this and plus 3 add 1, then you will get the same number, right? So on this we will find, we can understand that what is the remainder theorem. Okay, so here this polynomial f of x, sometimes we are representing into the form of p of x. Okay, so this polynomial p of x, it is divided by g of x. We got the question q of x plus remainder r of x. If you will compare the degree of the polynomial, okay, so degree of the divisor and degree of the remainder, if you compare the degree of the divisor and remainder, so what we have, we can say that degree of the divisor is always greater than the degree of the remainder. Here degree of divisor is always greater than the degree of remainder, or you can say degree of the remainder is always less than degree of divisor. Okay, so here what is the degree of divisor? It is 1, and here degree of remainder is, here not there anything, is x less to 0, so 0. Understood? Now we will see what is actual remainder theorem. Now we will see the remainder theorem. Remainder theorem is that, let suppose we P of x is any polynomial of degree greater than or equals to 1, which is divided by the g of x, or which is divided by g of x, and a be the any real number. A be the any real number means which is present into your divisor. If P of x is divided by x minus a, so divided by x minus a means this is your divisor, g of x, then the remainder is equals to the P of a. P of a means polynomial in that whatever your divisor x minus a, so x minus a that we have to equate with 0, and we have to find out what is the value of x here, so you will get x equals to a, and that in that P of x, what is your polynomial is given, in that we have to put the x with a, and then whatever you will get answer, that is the remainder is equals to P of a. With the help of example, now we will see actually what is the remainder theorem. Okay, so here before that we have taken that one example, minus x square was there, plus 2x cube minus 2x minus 7, that we have arranged in this descending order of your exponent. Okay, and g of x was given, that minus 2 plus x was there, that we have made their changes, x minus 2, right? So that same example we have taken here. Now we will carry out this division, but not actual division we will do, right? So it means that what is the value of this polynomial when we will put x minus 2, that is x minus 2 equals to, we have to take here as a x minus 2 equals to 0, that we will get x equals to 2. Okay, so this x equals to 2 means 2 is, that is your a be any real number. Okay, so that we have to put here. So f of 2 equals to 2 into 2 cube minus 2 square minus 2 into, what is value? 2, then minus 7. Okay, so here this 2, whatever we have kept the values for this x, we have to keep the bracket. Okay, then afterwards 2 multiplied by, what is the 2 cube? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, minus 2 square is 4 minus 4 minus 1. Okay, so here 2 8s are 16, minus 4 minus 4 minus 8 minus 7. Okay, so 16 minus 8, the 8 minus 7, so you will get 1. And this same remainder we have got when we have solved this such a examples to divide this polynomial by this divisor, with which division method, long division method, we got the same remainder, right? So this remainder you got here, f of 2 for this remainder. Okay, understood? So by using the remainder theorem, we have to find the remainder by this method. Okay, now we will see other examples. Next example is find the remainder where x cube minus 4x square plus 12x plus 7 is divided by x plus 1 by 2. Means we have to find the remainder by, without performing actual division. Means what? By using the remainder theorem, we have to find the remainder. Okay, so here in this remainder theorem, what if your divisor, is, suppose this is your f of x equals to x cube minus 4x square plus 12x plus 7. This is your polynomial f of x, which is divided by the divisor g of x equals to x plus 1 by 2. So here x plus 1 by 2 we have to find the value of x. It is this minus will be there, so minus 1 by 2. Okay, means actually how to write this x minus of minus 1 by 2. So here x, this minus will come there plus, but this shift we will to the right side of the 0. So you will get finally x equals to minus of bracket will shift to right side of the 0. So bracket number will be as it is, that is minus 1 by 2. And this minus of this bracket sign will come change into the plus. So finally you will get x equals to minus 1 by 2 in this way. Okay, so here we have to find f of minus 1 by 2. What is the x value we got here? Minus 1 by 2. Okay, so minus 1 by 2 is equals to x is what? Minus 1 by 2 cube minus 4 into x square is what? Minus 1 by 2 bracket square plus 12 into minus 1 by 2 plus 7. Okay. Then here, so next step is here, my f of minus 1 by 2 equals to, here what is the, every negative number having cube is always negative. So you will get negative values of this. So 1 cube is 1 minus 1 by 2 cube is 8. Okay. So here minus 4 multiplied by negative number having square is positive. So you will get 1 by 4. Now this plus minus will come minus. So here minus 2 1s are 2, 2 6s are 12. Correct? So here 6 1s are 6. So minus 6 and plus 7. Understood? Now here next step, this 4 4 will get cancelled. So you will get minus 1 by 8. This is of minus 1 minus 6 plus 7. Okay. So here this minus 6, minus 1 minus 6, minus 7, and this plus 7 will get cancelled. So finally you will get minus 1 by 8. This is your f of minus 1 by 2. Means this is your remainder. Okay. So this is your remainder. Understood everyone? So when you will divide this polynomial by this divisor x plus 1 by 2, so you will get minus 1 by 8 is your remainder. Okay, now we will see the next example. Find the remainder when pi x cube minus x square minus 6x minus 2 is divided by 1 minus pi x. So same concept is here. Here we will take that f of x, you can take p of x, no problem. So pi x cube minus x square minus 6x minus 2, and here your g of x equals to 1 minus phi x. So here 1 minus phi x, we have to find the value of x. Okay, so 1 equals to this minus phi x will be there to shift, then you will get plus phi x. So x equals to 1 by 5. So you got here x equals to 1 by 5 value. Okay, so we have to put here f of 1 by 5 equals to 5 into 1 by 5 cube. Okay. So here 5 into 1 by 5 cube minus 5 square means x square means 1 by 5 square minus 6 into 1 by 5 minus 2. Right? Now here f of 1 by 5 equals to here 5 into 1 upon 5 cube is 125 minus 1 upon 5 square is 25. Here minus this 6 by 5 minus 2. Right? So here 5 under 5, 5 to the 10, 2 remaining, 5 by the 25. So you got here 1 by 25 minus 1 by 25 minus 6 by 5 minus this 2, we will write 2 by 1, right? And here we will make here 1 by 25 minus 1 by 25, you get the answer. Here minus 6 by 5 minus 2, we will make the denominator same, that is 5, here 5. So here minus 6, then minus 10, and here we got the denominator same, so you will write here 5. So 16 minus 16 upon 5. Okay, so f of minus 1 by 5 for this, you got the minus 16 upon 5 is remainder. Understood everyone? So here, without division, prove that 2x cube plus 13x square plus x minus 17 is divisible by x minus 2. Okay. This number is divisible by x minus 2, that we have to prove. Okay. To prove means, whether if anyone will ask, is it 12 divisible by 4 means, is it 4 is the factor of 12 or is the 12 divisible by 4? Yes, of course, means by performing the division, 12 divided by 4, 4 threes are 12. What you are getting the remainder? Remainder is 0. Okay. So if any number is factor of the given number, then you will get it is remainder is 0. Means 12 is divisible by 4, then you will get the remainder is 0. Okay. So the same thing we want in the division. Means without carry out like this division, we want to prove that, we have to prove that 2x cube plus 13x square plus x minus 70 is divisible by x minus 2. Okay, so first we will find what is the value of x. So here p of x equals to 2x cube plus 13x square plus x minus 70, and your g of x equals to x minus 2. So we have to find the value of x for first. So x minus 2 equals to 0. So x equals to what? 2. Okay, so we will put this value of x here. P of 2 equals to 2 into x cube is 2 cube. 2 cube plus 13 into x square is 2 square. 2 square plus 2 minus 70. Okay. So here 2 into 2 cube is 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, plus 13 into 2 square is 4, plus 2 minus 17, right? So here 2 8's are 16 plus 13 4's are 52, plus 2 minus 17, okay? Here 6 plus 2, 8, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 2 minus 70. So 68 plus 2, it is 70, and 70 minus 70 equals to 0. Right? So you got the remainder is 0. Remainder is 0. So hence we can say that here 2x cube plus 13x square plus x minus 70 is divisible by x minus 2. Understood everyone? Now we will see the next example. See here the next example. Find the value of p for which the polynomial 2x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 2px square plus 3x plus 6 is divisible by x plus 2. Now in this example we have to find the value of p. But what is given? The given it is that the value of find the value of p for which the polynomial is divisible by x plus 2. Okay. So when any polynomial is divisible by a given, then if the remainder is 0, then only we can find. Okay. So here the polynomial f of x is, this given polynomial f of x is divisible by this x plus 2 if the remainder is 0. Okay. Here only it is given to find the value of for which, find the value of p for which the polynomial this is divisible by x plus 2. Okay. So when any polynomial. Polynomial f of x is divisible by x plus 2, means given polynomial, this polynomial, that it is divisible by x plus 2 if the remainder is 0. Understood? So by the remainder theorem, we will find out here f of x equals to 2x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 2p x square plus 3x plus 6. And what is your divisor? It is given g of x equals to x plus 2. This polynomial is divisible by this divisor if the remainder, means when it is possible, if the remainder is 0, then only we can see that this polynomial is divisible by x plus 2. Understood? So here x equals to what value will be the minus 2, and means that you will get f of minus 2 equals to 0. Understood? So what is the f of x? F of x equals to 2x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 2px square plus 3x plus 6. Right? So we have to put this value of x here, minus 2, and then we have to equate with 0. It means that f of x equals to 0. So what is the f of x? This here, right? So here 2x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 2p x raised to 2 plus 3x plus 6 equals to 0. So what is 2 into what is x value? Minus 2 raised to 4 plus 3 into minus 2 raised to 3 plus 2p value is not given, that we have to find out, into x means what? Minus 2 square plus 3 into minus 2 plus 6 equals to 0. So here 2 multiply, what is the 2 raised to 4? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. So 16 plus 3 into minus 2 cube is minus 8 plus 2p into 2 square is 4, minus 2 square is 4. And this plus minus will come minus, 3 to the 6 plus 6 equals to 0, right? So 16 twos are now here 32. Okay, now here plus minus, minus 8 threes are 24 plus 4 twos are 8t. Now this minus 6 plus 6 will get cancelled, so equals to 0, right? So 32 minus 24, how much? 8. Okay, then plus 8p equals to 0. Now this only the single number will shift to right side of the 0. So 8p equals to minus 8. So p equals to minus 8 by 8. So p equals to what? Minus 1. Understood everyone?